All right, let's now continue with our coverage. And meanwhile, President Uhuru Kenyatta will continue with his tour of the Central Kenya region later today, where he will visit Murang'a County. Now, he is expected to visit Kerugoya and Murang'a Level 5 hospitals, inspect the ongoing construction of the 29-kilometer stretch Kutus Kianyaga Kimudhugu Kithure Kibugi Road. He will also commission the Kangema Gasharage Road and launch the Murang'a Mukuyu Guadamaki Road in Murang'a County. Yesterday, Uhuru, with his deputy William Ruto, accused the opposition of embarking on a smear campaign to promote their voter apathy in the support base.
Asking ourselves, how can we move this country forward?
Nini mutakubali ya kwamba tutaendelea na mipango na maendeleo ya Jubilee ama mnataka makelele na maandamano ya kwa.
All right, so let's now link up with Alan Mungai. He is our reporter here at Standard Group to tell us more about President Uhuru Kenyatta's second day tour. Thank you so much, Alan, for joining us. Maybe you can just talk to us about when will these events take place. It seems like it's a quite a heavy day for the president there, apart from launching and, you know, seeing this projects. What else will he be up to today?
Yeah, good morning, Betty. As you have said, the president has had a really busy day yesterday. This will be second day. A dispatch from State of yesterday say that it will be a whirlwind 48 hours for the president. Yesterday he was in Chaka, in Arumoru and Nanyuki, and he also made talks in Nyeri as late as 7:30 p.m. Today he will be in Murang'a and then later in Kerugoya, where, as you have said, he'll make stops at the Kirinyaga District Hospital and then later commission road projects in Kerugoya and Murang'a. But what is expected to feature in the president's itinerary today is he will talk about the issues of voter apathy and neglect of the region, which have really featured in recent times, where they have been claimed that the president has really neglected the region. And seeing as this is his biggest vote basket, it is a region that is really crucial to him. So yesterday, the president made clear to assure the voters that I have not neglected the region, where he commissioned projects of as much as 13 billion shillings, launching hospitals, road projects, and also his deputy, William Ruto, made it clear that there was no voter apathy in the region. That is just a creation of the opposition, which has been funded by the media, and also local leaders in, like Kipia in Nyeri, assured the president and his deputy that our people will still make sure they vote for him. But it is also good to know that the president steered clear of local politics, and aside from a case in Nanyuki where the local governor was booed by the residents, but the president and his deputy made sure not to mention anything about local politics, aside from assuring the residents that the nominations will be held in a free and fair manner.
Right.
No. Okay.
Right, Alan. Sorry for cutting you short, but you know, let's just go back to that issue about voter apathy that, you know, the president spoke you know, a lot about yesterday. Looking at the sentiments of the residents there, is he assured of the same support base come 2017?
If we can go by the numbers that stand out yesterday, by the show of support that the president got yesterday, it is safe to say that the people are still as enthusiastic as they were in 2013, and this is something that a number have come out saying that no, we'll still come out and vote for you in 2013. What was reported in the media may not be the correct position, but the president still says that this, you're my people, you're still in my development agenda, and I still lean on your support in the coming elections.
All right, let's talk a bit about and expand this conversation to, you know, criticism against the Jubilee government that they've not been able to, you know, to be successful in the war against graft. Is this a factor that, you know, voters there seem to, you know, care about?
Yeah, it is important to note that for these issues of voter apathy to come up, they were instigated by the claims of corruption against the government, where so many people were saying that we voted overwhelmingly for this government, but with these issues of corruption coming up, we may not be really feeling the same way about voting for you in 2013. And the president really came out yesterday and assured the residents that what you're hearing about corruption, Eurobond, health scandal, NOS, they did not touch on my government. No money was stolen. That was just what the opposition created to discredit my presidency, to,
right.
to you people. So I think it's something that is really crucial to the president, and he will talk about the same thing today. And as you may have seen, that he really took his time to castigate the opposition for coming up with, he said that he was peddling lies concerning corruption in his government.
All right. Thank you so much, Alan Mungai, for that reporting. Of course, we're going to keep you updated on the events taking place in central Kenya, where President Uhuru Kenyatta is continuing with his tour. This is the second day. All right. So we want to take a